and sort of colour, air quality, very much as we become acoustic, it's a very nice environmental surface. It has a entertainment for this, which I think, most of environmentally, is probably all we want to occur. Unfortunately, that means that the windows are open. talk about children. I think children are a lot more resilient to temperature change. There's new research to show that children like cooler conditions, both winter and summer. I hope to see that some of that is pressed this year. We'll be showing that probably the comfort temperature of children will be 2 or 3 degrees less than adults. And that's a problem in the teacher. You can show you can control the heating and ventilating system. You've got very good control. Teachers will, unless they have to be sitting away from the job, it's going to be quite confusing. If the desk is away from the window, that might work. But the cold conditions will be where the children are. It's very important to integrate the systems that we design into the architecture of the building, the vents, the blinds, the windows. All needs to be thought of as one holistic design. So often they're not. I just wanted to make a point. I don't think there's any limit to how much daylight is good for human life. Recent studies have shown that where children are deprived of daylight, there's a long time indoors, don't have enough outside activity. Even correlated with increases in myopia populations that have increased the amount of time that children are in the world, specifically Eastern countries, China, Malaysia. The level of myopia has gone up very, very considerably. And our people are linking that to low levels of daylight. It has been said that children should have 3 days, 3 hours outdoors in the daylight every day. When you talk about comfort, I think it's quite important to differentiate between what is comfort and what is discomfort, what is actually burden on poor health. It's always trying to develop up with comfort. Is that important to be comfortable? Is it good for you? You know, you perform better on academic thoughts when you start a young couple. We improve in the first term here. 2 degrees C lower temperature improves the temperature of the students by significant amounts. So to chase comfort is not necessarily the answer. You don't want to have ill health by it. And with daylight design, in the past, we had average daylight vessels used at this time, which led to a lot of glare and a lot of underpeat. And very important informative data. John has come up with one of the best daylight modeling, which looks at the useful daylight for the real task. So that's where the difficulty comes in, because if you're not trying to do a difficult visual task, you don't need to live with that. Unfortunately, the human grasp is subjective to this all the time, very poorly, very slowly often. It's an incredibly visually demanding task. We have to have a visually demanding environment. So we're not designing to cope necessarily, we're designing to cope with what we're imposing on our children. But they have to sit there and relate to something. Which is good for some children. So what we're trying to do in school is get an environment that will be adequate for the task. Those are moving into other spaces. Corridors which are not dated. And I think the Circadian rhythm research is quite important. And that your mood is affected. If you can see daylight in any part of your peripheral vision, the Circadian receptors are not. It has to do with focus. They give more distributed around the world. So even though I've only just glimpsed the daylight in this room, it's better for my health than the room. That's the theory which is called the professor about how to come to that. We do need daylight in all aspects. And so we've got the criteria that always must have daylight. We don't buy this idea that sports people say you can't have any daylight or any less. acoustics are very important issues. It has a detrimental effect on the learning and study. And these things have been proved by quite comprehensive studies, according to books by the population of the university, etc. One of the main important things is speech interference, speech intelligibility. So all the factors that we're trying to control in the group, main aim is to improve the speech intelligibility of the multi-modular task. Things to remember is that a lot of children have technical hearing impairments in their environment. And at young age, they're trying to decipher sound. So their speech is not, their audio cognition is not developed until about 13 years of age. So this says that in the USA, I think 40% of children in primary school class could have some form of technical impairment. So the main thing to think about is the speech recognition ratio. How do you allow them to to make a pleasant environment for sleeping, eating food, and we can't really afford to have every glass with such a level of control that it can be very difficult to adapt precisely. So how do you do this? What? This is the idea of floor surface in the standard. So lowering is not about the maximum ability. Does that mean you can't have dunes in the barefoot unless you've got 100 feet? Seems like the standard could drive a very restricted solution. If you don't even have quite a bit of leeway. These are just ideas. They're not proven for children. These never happen. They need to prove for adults. Climate change. An air conditioned environment. Not the natural environment. You've got control over it to do that. People are now saying, we need to look directly at our environment. We need to be able to do that. We don't want to see this as a comfort box. It's, preconditioned. Is that really what we want to do with more of an interaction with our mind? So it's actually a difficult thing to set a standard for thermal comfort, which is broad enough to allow designers enough freedom to use their own mind. What can go wrong is when you have a steady state temperature, like a non-moving mind, 28 degrees C, allowed to be seen for 120 hours during the school year. Now that's too broad a level. It's basically too high a level for too long a time. And you might work with a robust natural ventilation solution when you've got a mechanical ventilation system between 28 degrees to 120 hours. It could also be achieved in 25 degrees to 500 hours, which would be very uncomfortable. So we come to that thermal comfort. Trying to work through that is not easy because the standards